JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's Daily Market Review for September the 30th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, Head of Research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar kept marching north against all the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It rose the most versus NZD, GBP, the Euro and AUD in that order, while it decked out the least gains against CHF and JPY. The strengthening of the US dollar, the weakening of the risk-linked Kiwi, Pound and Aussie, as well as the fact that the safe havens yen and franc lost the least ground, all suggest that market participants remain concerned and worried. However, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that major EU indices rebounded, and although appetite softened again during the US session, only Nasdaq closed in negative waters. Today in Asia, China Shanghai Composite and South Korea's KOSPI gained, while Japan's Nikkei 225 and Hong Kong's Hang Seng slid. Now, despite the rebound in some equity indices yesterday, the strengthening of the US dollar and the other safe haven currencies suggests that market participants have not suddenly forgotten what forced them to abruptly abandon equities on Tuesday. As we noted yesterday, we would treat a near-term recovery as a short covering corrective bounce. We see decent chances for equity to resume their declines, and we will explain why right now. First, Fed Chair Jerome Powell, ECB President Lagarde, and Bank of England Governor Andrew Bailey all shared the view that inflation remains and could remain elevated for longer than they have estimated, although they maintained the view that the surge in prices could still prove to be transitory. Their comments added to speculation for earlier than previously expected tightening by the Fed and the Bank of England. The reason we cannot say the same about the ECB is because this bank made it clear that it can tolerate overshooting inflation and refused to discuss tapering. Remember that at its latest gathering, the ECB slowed its purchases but hinted that it could compensate through other schemes when the program ends. In our view, the ECB would prefer to move too late rather than too early. Second, the deadlock between Congress Democrats and Republicans persists, increasing the risk of a government default and a shutdown. Senate Democrats have tried to pass a bill that funds the government and prevents a catastrophic default by raising the nation's debt ceiling. However, Republicans opposed to the proposal. The government hits the ceiling on October 18th, and lawmakers are due to vote on a potential resolution to fund operations through early December today, before funding expires. A potential breakthrough could provide a temporary relief, but it would be far from a permanent solution. Thus, the risk of a potential government shutdown remains well on the table. Last but not least, China's Evergrande failed once again to proceed with coupon payments yesterday, something that increases concerns over a default, which could have a spillover effect to the nation's financial system and even to the rest of the world. As we noted yesterday, Evergrande has 30 days past the scheduled date to settle the payments of any bond. Otherwise, the bond defaults. Now, back to the currencies, the pound was the second loser in line behind the New Zealand dollar, despite increasing expectations that the Bank of England could raise its benchmark interest rate in the months to come. The British currency has been the best performing one at some point earlier this year, boosted by high expectations over an economic rebound due to the country's vaccination program. However, it came under strong selling interest the last couple of days, hitting its lowest since end 2020 against the US dollar yesterday on Wednesday, due to concerns about soaring natural gas, prices, and nearly a week of petrol shortages. People have been panic buying fuel as oil firms warned that they don't have enough truck drivers to carry petrol and diesel from refineries to filling stations. What's more, the correlation between sterling and risk sentiment has increased lately, which leaves the currency vulnerable when investors reduce their risk exposure. Now, as for today's events, during the European session, Germany releases its preliminary inflation data for September. Both CPI and HICP year-over-year rates are expected to have risen further to 4.2 and 3.8% from 3.9 and 3.4% respectively. This may raise speculation that the Eurozone's headline rate due out tomorrow may rise as well. From the UK and the US, we have the final GDP prints for the second quarter. The UK numbers are already out and they are slightly higher than their initial estimates, while later in the day, the US forecasts suggest a confirmation of their second estimates. Tomorrow, Asian time, Japan's Tankan survey for the third quarter is due to be released, with the large manufacturers index expected to have ticked down to 13 from 14, but the large non-manufacturers index forecast to have risen to 3 from 1. The nation's employment report for August is also coming out. As for the speakers, we have four Fed members on our agenda, and those are New York President John Williams, Atlanta President Raphael Bostic, Philadelphia President Patrick Harker, and Chicago President Charles Evans. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.